Core is really important. Our core is our connection to our breath. It's our balance, our strength, our confidence. In the chakras, we have our third chakra. It's our connection to fire and passion, and it's the thing that gets us up off the couch and gets us going out and creating things. And the core takes investment. It takes a lot of effort to really work core. I've been getting emails and students who have been very sweetly writing and saying things to the effect of, well, I know that I'm not supposed to be so worried about what my body looks like, but I have this kind of thing here and it just makes me feel really gross and sluggish and just don't feel so confident anymore. And that's when core becomes important. It's important that we feel that connection to our confidence and to our breath. We have this inborn confidence in us that we so often have as kids and then we lose as adults. So this class is going to be for those of you who are wanting to take the physical core and the metaphorical core to that next level, to that next place. So this is, if you're new to me or you're new to free yoga, please go and take our 30 days of yoga before trying this class. And for those of you that have been with me for a while, I would suggest to do this class incrementally. So maybe you only make it through 15 minutes the first time. Maybe it's 5, whatever it might be. This is going to be an investment. So with that in mind, I would suggest turning on a heater if you have one, and we are going to get into some really deep core breath work. So then we can take that breath work into the asana. So let's sit nice and tall. Close the eyes, relax the shoulders, the knees, and check in with the breath. Actually, before you close your eyes, I want you to notice how we breathe. So we want to breathe down into the belly, and it might look a little strange. I've been doing pranayama for a long time, so I have what I like to call my prana belly. So when I inhale in, my whole core becomes active, and then exhale out, and using that full core. So inhale, maybe pressing into a hand. Exhale, pressing out. Inhale in deeply for 3, 2, 1. Exhale out, 3, 2, 1. Deep inhale in, let the belly fill up. Spine a little longer. Exhale, pressing out. Keep the length in that spine. Use the core to press out a little extra air. Already starting to feel the warmth being generated. Inhale, fill the whole belly up. Exhale, pressing out. Inhale, reach the arms out and up. Bring the palms together. Exhale them down in between the eyes. May your practice cultivate enlightened thoughts. Inhale, exhale, the hands in front of the mouth. May your practice cultivate enlightened speech. Inhale, exhale, the hands in front of the heart. May all of your practices cultivate an enlightened heart. We're going to come into breath of fire first. If you already know breath of fire, you can come right into it. We're going to be using this breath a lot, so I want you to become comfortable with this breath. If you're not used to breath of fire, take your left hand on your diaphragm and take your other hand in front of your mouth, and you're going to fog it up like you would a mirror. Again, pumping the core. Pressing into that hand. As you're ready, transfer the breath to your nose. Focusing on the exhales, find a rhythm. You can connect the index finger and thumb. Really feel the belly start to dance. Find your own rhythm. If you're going a little faster, a little slower, be sure that the belly keeps pumping. Let it be the bellows. If you lose it, just take a breath and come back in. Really start to feel that warmth being generated. Feel the length in the spine. You can get a complete core workout just by doing this breath for long enough and doing it properly. Really using the core. Use that whole pumping of your core. Take a huge inhale in, reach the fingers up. Belly spill out, sip in a little more air in through the mouth. And exhale it out. Let the hands come down. If you have a little zafu like I do, or a little cushion, pull that out to the side. We're gonna float the toes up off the earth. Hold on behind the knees, sit up nice and tall. Now find some deep breaths. And we're going to start to engage the core. Bring the shins parallel to the earth. Get your chest a little higher. Now as the core is engaged, a lot of times what starts to happen is that the breath stops. But we still want to breathe into the active core. So even though I'm holding myself up with my core, I'm still using my core to breathe. Fingertips down. Straighten the legs if you'd like. Fingertips all the way up if you can. Same deep breaths. Now we're going to take an inhale in. Exhale, float just an inch up off the earth. Inhale up. Exhale, float. Inhale, reach. Exhale, float. Maybe we're inhaling to here, but keep the core engaged. Move with the breath. Next time we find ourselves down, we're going to float. Now we're going to pump the hands. And on each exhale, we're going to press the hands down for breath of fire. And release down. All the way to your mat. Whew. Hopefully you're already feeling a little warm. I know I am. Keep that warmth going. Keep the breath long. Keep pressing the belly. And slightly close off the back of your throat for Ujjayi breath. Same long inhales and long exhales, consciously working into the core. We're going to lift the heels straight up toward the sky. Engage the quads. Try and get your heels a little closer up toward the ceiling. And in case you were wondering, right now we are connecting the core and the breath. So This is one of the reasons why the core is so important. Because when we start to feel overwhelmed, our core tenses up and we can't take a breath. So we are purposefully creating all of this tension in the nervous system. So that way the core has a lot to do and then can be connected to breath. So we're going to lift the head and shoulders. Try and get the shoulder blades up. We're going to reach the fingertips straight forward. Take an inhale. Try and get the heels a little higher. And we're going to pump the hands again as we exhale. Try and keep the spine long. Try and get the chest high. On an inhale, reach for the fingertip, reach for the toes. Hold the breath at the top. Open the mouth, exhale it out. We're gonna roll onto our stomach. Place the elbows down, right under the shoulders. Place the fingers out. Pull the chest forward, open through the whole core. Rock gently from side to side. Really opening up the core. Deep inhale in. Open the mouth, let it out. We're going to interlace the fingers, except for the pinky and ring finger. Press those down. I'm going to tuck the toes, let your chest come down towards your hands so you can start to engage your core. So we don't want to lift from the low back, but we want to lift from our core. Feel the core start to rise until the center of the back is the highest point. Pull the elbows toward each other and back towards your big toes. Lengthen through the crown of the head, same deep breaths. On an inhale, choose the left hand first, coming up to plank. Exhale, left elbow first, down to forearm plank. Inhale, right hand first. Exhale, right elbow first. Inhale, up to plank. Try to not let the hips go too far side to side. Exhale, down. Try to keep everything right to the center. Inhale, right hand first. Exhale, right elbow first. One more time each side. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Again, place the hips down. Place the palms down. And breathe. Nice sphinx. Same deep breaths. A lot of times working in the core, we get into our digestion and everything else. So a lot of times, little bits of nausea come up. And we don't want to push ourselves to the point where we actually throw up, because that's a horrible feeling. So we want to be kind and patient with ourselves. We're going to sit back on our heels. Go ahead and tuck the toes right into those glutes. Sit up nice and tall. Take some deep breaths, press the belly out. Press it all the way back. Inhale, pull it out. Exhale, press it back. Inhale. Exhale one last time. Now we're going to hold empty. With the breath empty, we're just going to pump the stomach. 15 times. Inhale. Exhale, press the belly. When it's empty, pump. Pump 15 times. Inhale. Exhale one last time. With it empty. Pump. Inhale in. Open mouth, let it out. That pumping with the breath empty is a really good way to get the digestion moving, get the core moving. Now let's place the hands out. We're going to come into downward facing dog. Just for a moment, release through the hips, release through the shoulders. Be sure the tension isn't traveling from the core to other spots in the body. Now we're going to come forward to plank. Be sure that the hands are right under the shoulders. Pull the hands toward each other. Keep the pectorals engaged. Engage the core. Get the low back a little higher. Same deep breaths. Bring the feet together back behind you. We're going to inhale, roll onto the outside of the left foot. Reach the right fingers up. Get the hips a little higher. We'll take an inhale in. Exhale, we're going to drop the hips. Be sure that the left shoulder stays right over the left wrist. And then inhale, lift the hips. Exhale, drop. Inhale, lift. Exhale, drop. Inhale, lift. Exhale, drop. Inhale, lift. If this is a little too much on that shoulder, you can come down to your forearm. Keep moving with your breath. Keep lengthening through the spine. Now we're going to come through center, either on the elbows or on the hand. Roll over to the right side and left fingers up. Find your steady here. And then inhale, get the hips a little higher. Exhale, drop the hips down. Inhale, lift. Exhale, drop. Inhale, lift. Move with your breath again. You can come down to that forearm if you need to. This can be a lot on the wrists and that shoulder. Keep moving with your breath. One more inhale. Exhale, coming down through center. We're going to exhale all the way through a nice vinyasa and heading back, downward facing dog. Now we're going to start to warm up the entire body. Make sure we don't just get stuck in our core. And let's inhale, come up to the balls of the feet, turn the gaze forward, walk to the front of the mat. Exhale, down, forward fold. Some nice quick sun salutations. Inhale, halfway up. Hello, flower. Exhale, down. Forward fold, inhale, reach the fingers out and up. Exhale, lead with the heart down to the toes. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, plant the hands, step or jump back and down. Inhale, through and up, your back bend of choice. Exhale, back, downward facing dog. Inhale, coming up to the balls of the feet, turn gaze forward, step or float. Exhale, down, forward fold. Inhale, reach the arms out and up. Exhale, lead with the heart. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, plant the hands, step or float. Exhale all the way down, inhale through and up. Exhale, back downward facing dog. Inhale, coming up to the balls of the feet, turn the gaze forward, step or float. Exhale, down, forward fold. Inhale, reach the arms out and up. Exhale, lead with the heart. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, plant the hands, stepping, floating. Inhale through and up. Exhale, back downward facing dog. Inhale, balls of the feet, turn the gaze forward, step or float. Inhale, reach. Exhale, forward fold. This time, so inhale, halfway up. We're going to take the weight over to the right foot, reach the left foot back. So now we're going to move into how the core keeps us balanced. So the fingertips are down. That left hip is not stacking on top of the right. Feel the core pulling in and up, and see if you can start to take the weight out of your hands. If you need to, you can keep the fingertips down. Stack that left hip on top of the right. Reach the left fingers up if you'd like. Now notice if the core is not engaged, then the balance is a lot harder. I'm going to keep the core engaged, especially those left obliques, lengthening through the crown of the head. Same deep breaths. On an inhale, we're going to bring the left knee up into the chest. Exhale, reach that left heel all the way back. Hands to heart center, open up. Ardha Chandrasana. Inhale, bring the left knee in. Exhale, send it back. You can head to Ardha Chandrasana or Virabhadrasana 3. Inhale, pull it in. Exhale, send it back. Inhale, pull it in. Exhale, place it down next to the right. Inhale, reach the fingers. Exhale, lead with the heart. Inhale, halfway up, stay there. Reach that right heel back. Feeling that core engage, feeling the spine long, again, floating onto those fingertips. Stacking that right hip on top of the left. Keep the left fingers down if you need to, but try to keep the core engaged as you float. On an inhale, bring that right knee into your chest. Exhale, send it back. All the way to Ardha Chandrasana if you'd like. Inhale, pull it in. Exhale, send it back. Inhale, bring it in. Exhale, send it back. Keep it in the core. Inhale in one more time. Place it down. Inhale, reach the fingers up. Exhale, lead with the heart. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, plant the hands, stepping back to plank. Take an inhale in, engage the core, center of the back high. Exhale, one elbow at a time, down to forearm plank, interlace the fingers. This time we're going to lift the right heel, inhale in. Exhale, right knee to right elbow. Inhale, reach that heel back. Exhale, pull it in. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull it in. Inhale, reach. Exhale, place it down. Inhale, left heel up. Exhale, left knee, left elbow. Inhale, reach it back. Exhale, pull it in. Inhale it back. Exhale, pull it in. Inhale it back one more time. Exhale, place it down. Take the right fingertips to the left elbow. We're going to inhale, roll onto the outside of the right elbow. Exhale, left fingers to the right elbow. Left elbow down. Inhale, reach. Exhale through center. Inhale, reach. Exhale to 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 center one more time. This time, place the fingers out. Place the hips down. Roll the shoulders back. Ah. Nice Sphinx. Notice the thoughts and the breath. Notice the focus. Let's bring the hands back toward the ribs. Pull the elbows toward each other. And then press ourselves up for tabletop. And let's tuck the toes. And then lift the knees an inch up off the earth. Using that core, using the breath, pulling the hands toward each other, back toward your knees. Deep breaths. And send the hips up and back, downward facing dog. Release one heel and the other. Be sure the hips are not getting crazy, but still staying open. And then forward to plank. and down to our backs. Bring the soles of the feet together, let the knees fall out to the side. Right hand to the heart, left hand to the diaphragm. Breathe into that left hand. Now these moments of rest are very important when we're working on changing the nervous system. Because if we just work insanely hard and we don't give ourselves any time to let these new parts of our nervous system sink in and open up, then the change comes quickly and then leaves just as quickly. So we are trying to change the composition of our nervous system. Not just short fixes, but permanent changes. Still feeling warm. Maybe letting the heartbeat slow down just a little bit. Now let's press the feet together, place the hands down underneath the thighs. We're going to engage the core and lift the feet. And slowly start to take the feet so that they're pointing up toward the sky, but the knees are still working their way out to the sides. Same breaths. And on an inhale, lift the hips and try and get your toes a little closer to the ceiling. Inhale. Exhale, release. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Release the feet, heels up. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, and exhale. Inhale, and exhale. On an inhale, reach the heels up. Try and keep that float, keep the breath long. Slowly lower the left heel so it's an inch up off the earth. Keep the quads engaged, keep the core engaged. Keep that right heel lifting, keep that left heel reaching out. Slowly switch the leg. Move with control. Notice all the little spots where the legs or the core are trying to skip. And then notice if some of the work is coming up into the shoulders and in the neck. Your neck is not required for your core to work. It's something I see a lot with my clients is that we tend to think our neck can somehow help our core. And so then all of our stress goes up into our neck, both heels up. Try and get them a little higher. And again, noticing if the neck is relaxed. Now our core is capable of burning up all this stress. Our core is very strong. It's our connection to that fire. So let that burn. Let that burn strong. It's capable of doing that. Your shoulders and your neck are not so capable of that. They can't hold the whole world up. Build from the bottom up. Feel that strength and foundation. Heels a little higher. Try and get the tailbone up. Relax the shoulders and neck. Inhale in. Count of eight to yourself. Exhale out. Lower the heels. Pull the heels in towards your glutes, hip distance apart, press the heels down, lift the hips up, maybe coming into a nice supported bridge to really let the core go. And lift the right heel up, Really feel that nice opening through the low back. And left heel. Coming up to the balls of the feet and gently lowering down. Pull that right knee in. Now we're going to straighten the left leg out. Keep that heel just an inch up off the earth. Relax the right toes. Lift the head and shoulders. Interlace the hands behind the neck. Open the elbows. And breathe. And breath of fire. When you just can't do it anymore, release that sigh, stretch out the legs, stretch out the arms. Pull that left knee in. Float the right toes, lift the heart. Breathe, or breath of fire. Time. Nice bridge. Support it if you'd like. Keep those long inhales and long exhales. Balls of the feet, roll down one vertebra at a time. We're almost there. Reach the heels up. Reach the fingers toward that little space in between your arches. Take an inhale in. Exhale, float up to boat. Take an inhale in, exhale the fingers to the right, inhale to center, exhale left, inhale to center, exhale right, move with your breath, this is going to be one of those where you go till you just can't go anymore. When the knees start to bend, keep going. As long as you can keep breathing, keep going. You're still with me. Huge inhale in. Reach everything up. Hold the breath. Sip it a little more air in through the mouth. Open the mouth. Let it out. Float it down. Roll onto your stomach for a moment. Elbows underneath the shoulders. Release the core. Oh my goodness. Breathe. Breathe. Breathe and let it all go. And roll onto your back. We've made it. We're alive. Pull that right knee into the chest. Pull it over the body with the right hand. Be sure that the low back is nice and open, relaxed. Use that opposite hand to press that hip away. And grab the other side. Slowing down. Feeling all that warmth, feeling that confidence. And you've just done something really good for your whole body. That confidence and understanding that it takes time, it takes investment, it takes energy. And as you take each long inhale and long exhale, knowing that it is so worth it, you are worth it, your body is worth it. This time, starting to let all that work and warmth settle in the body, feeling it settling down with the gravity as it pulls you down heavier and heavier. Letting the breath come easier. Being with each inhale and each exhale. Knowing that the body is healing itself. The nervous system is finding more space. Your only job at this point is just to let go. Take a deep breath in. Listening to that breath, decide if you would like to stay in Shavasana or start to activate the body, however feels natural. Rolling onto one side or the other, and you can find your way back to a comfortable seated position. However you'd like to round out your practice. Notice if the nervous system is a little calmer, if the breath is coming a little easier, the thoughts seem a little bit further apart. And notice if the core is a little more alive. It's a little more strength in each breath. A little more confidence in the way you hold yourself. A little more ease in finding our center. Inhale, reach the arms out and up. Bring the palms together, exhale them down in between the eyes. May your life be filled with enlightened thoughts. Inhale, exhale, the hands in front of the mouth. May you always have the patience for enlightened speech. Inhale, exhale, the hands in front of the heart. May your heart have the healing it requires to live an enlightened life. Namaste. Take your time. There is no rush. I just want to thank you all so much for allowing me to guide you. This is truly a wonderful, wonderful community at Free Yoga TV, and I just want to thank you. I'm excited to grow into this next place with you guys, and as most of you know, these are all donation-based classes, and we ask that you honor the suggested $15 donation if you're able, or leave whatever you can, and if you can't leave anything monetarily, then we ask that you put forward $15 worth of your time. So whatever that means for you. Maybe it's you tell 15 people about Free Yoga TV, or you do some breath work with a loved one who's in a really stressful place, or you share this video on social media, whatever you feel will take the energy from this class and somehow pay it forward. So that's really what all of this work comes down to, is how do we allow all of this work that we do on our mats to spill over into our lives and into everything else we do. Thank you for allowing me to be a part. Thank you for this community. Thank you.